that you're kind of possibly a new direction is to organize the work more thematically. And then already within the work that's been done, all of the case examples the forum has been looking at, identified these different types of water conflicts. And so I was just wondering what kinds of different types water conflicts come in the form of, and mm-hmm. how these types differ from one another.
Mm-hmm. Let's start with our discussion of the book itself. The book itself tried to, document different type of conflicts. Though it's an incomplete exercise, but at least it gives you some type of a pointer to different type of conflicts which is taking place. So I think we have tried to understand conflicts like, for example, contending water uses. Mm-hmm. That is one type of conflict, where we say that when one unit of water is being, you know, contested over for use, like for example, you know, agriculture versus industry, or ecosystem versus other type of thing, or domestic water needs versus other type of thing, or cultural needs versus something else. So when one unit of water gets allocated across different uses, or how that water gets allocated, there's a contested water. That's what basically what you call it, contending water uses. And that also primarily emerged from the whole, special nature of water, or the peculiarity of water, which emerges from the common pool nature actually. Because common pool nature of water, which basically says that a unit of water which is allocated for one use cannot be allocated for something else.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Unlike, let's say, public good.
Yes.
Public good is something, for example, both of us are sitting under this tube light, let's say. Now, whether two of us sit or 100 people sit, everybody gets the same amount of light to some extent, like a street light, for example.
Yeah.
That's a good example of a common public good type of a thing. So, water is a
So you were just talking about the difference between water being a
common pool resource and not a public good. Yeah.
Yes.
So a whole lot of conflicts around contending water uses, this is the main issue which is there. So in the book we have talked about quite a few cases about examples of such type of conflicts that are taking place in the country. Now if you heard about in Rajasthan, there is this famous area called Bharatpur Sanctuary. It's a Ramsar site and a World Heritage site and things. And a lot of migratory birds come there, especially Siberian cranes and things. So there's this national park called, it's called the Bharatpur Wetlands or the Kewaldev National Park and things. Now there the whole conflict has been the type of water which is required for the park there and the ecosystem around it. And the people who are living, adjoining that whole area, as farmers who are using the water for farming. So I think a couple of centuries ago the then ruling, the king there, did construct a couple of bunds or a couple of dams and type of thing to provide water then because of the growing agriculture and other things. And also Bharatpur itself is a big town and there the population has been growing. So the whole needs of the Bharatpur town and the adjoining villages and their agriculture versus this. So that became pretty complex and intense. Few years back, and especially this conflict comes much more serious than there is a below normal rainfall and type of thing. So that is one example of how, what broadly one can call an ecosystem versus people's livelihood needs have been a conflict to some extent. So similar type of cases you can find in many places. Or in Kerala you have a very interesting conflict called the Sandal Kuttanad. That is supposed to be the rice bowl of Kerala. That's the whole area where you have for rice cultivation, and that's an area also which is actually below sea level, actually physically.
Yes.
Yeah. So people take one crop of paddy there, and to cultivate that paddy you need to actually pump out water from there to the outside, otherwise you don't have the drainage like this. Now interestingly, fishermen and agriculture have been coexisting earlier there. Then what happened is because of the pressure from the agriculture, what happened is that because of the sea water started ingressing into the lake, the Kuttanad lake there and that kind of thing, which was affecting the paddy fields. So there's a massive structure they created, like a barrier,
mm-hmm.
to arrest the seawater ingestion into this whole thing.
Yes.
That created a lot of ecological problems because a lot of mosquito breeding and other type of thing, water was not draining out and things. So that had ecological impact on type of a thing. And it also affected the fishermen's livelihoods because the whole fish production was based on this whole, what you call the interesting exchange between this whole balance between the sea and the freshwater type of thing which is taking place. Once that was blocked, then there was a massive issue there. So what we find is that even structures which are created to take care of some of this effect actually become the cause for new conflicts to come up. So there are different type of these conflicts which are taking place around this. Or there's a famous case of Delhi getting water from various other type of hinterlands and type of thing. You know, this, or urban versus rural, for example.
Yeah.
Chennai has got this interesting case where a whole lot of water tankers come from the rural areas and people have got wells in the rural area. Earlier they were taking agriculture crops with their water. Now they find much more lucrative to sell this water to the urban population. So there are people who want to use the water for agriculture and people who want to sell their water for in city so that they get a quick money. And they are going for deeper and deeper wells, affecting the other people's this. So there's a conflict
yes.
between the well owners who want to sell the water and who want to use it for agriculture. So there are new types of conflicts taking place around contending water uses. So that is one type of conflict we are trying to address. Second,